That's what disobeying orders feels like. Not so good.
Thank you. Thank you. Did you figure it out?
Please say yes.
Yeah, we're good to go. With this, I can destroy the Binding Stone. We just have to get close enough to Sandrak.
How do you propose we do that when we don't even know where he is?
This mark gives me a connection to the Binding Stone. I can feel where it is. I can feel where Sandrak is. He's moving east, towards the Deepmere.
There's a font in the ocean.
Sounds like it. All right, pack it in! We're leaving soon!
What's the play, sir?
Devon and I will stay here at the Shrine Forge for a bit. See if we can find anything else of interest.
And rig it to blow when the Roshanians return.
You need to get back to the Palathon and brief Kirkan. She'll figure out our next steps. But when you use that mark to destroy the Binding Stone, I want to be there. I want to see Sandrak's face when you just crumble it in his hand.
Yeah, we are really just, you know, gonna destroy that Binding Stone so hard. Yeah.
Fuck yeah. Now head back to the Palathon.
Impressive place, huh?
It really is. The Aristeia were exceptional builders. How do you think Sandrak found out about it?
Probably dumb luck. Soko mentioned Roshanian airships started taking new routes into Lucium.
When parts of the Oriman border collapsed, right. So, they discover this Shrine Forge.
And Sandrak's able to use his new mark to detect the location of the Binding Stone.
In Ilthium.
Yep. No wonder it seemed like Sandrak was overextending himself there. He was. Desperate to find that temple.
Doesn't seem fair. Accidentally finding a doomsday weapon. Hard work should go into something like that.
All right. I better go.
Oh, don't forget to say hello and goodbye to Kenzie for me when you return to the Palathon.
Will do. Great call getting her to come in. We wouldn't be here without her help. I'm back at the Palathon.
Well done, soldier. Meet me in the vault. We can finally have that conversation that I've been trying to avoid.
Sir?
Back here, Jack. Here. This dossier is for you. My report of Sandrak's time as an immortal. Some details remain classified.
This will have to do, then. Thank you, sir.
Come. Show me the mark you recovered from the Shrine Forge.
Sure.
It lets you feel the movements of the Binding Stone?
Yeah. Sandrak's definitely sailing the Deep Mere. But his movements are weird. Erratic.
Unfortunately, we can't afford to send a large force out to sea. Most of the Light's army musters at the front, and we need them to remain there. You, Zendara, and Devon will have to face Sandrak alone. Well, not exactly alone. My contacts in the Clayless Traders Guild provided us with a colossal during the Trenchship Rebellion. I never gave it back. It'll take time to wake her up. She's not seen service in a very long time. Captain Selko's a fine steersman, if I recall correctly.
And I can guide him to wherever Sandrak is using my mark.
That's the plan. Now, unless you have something else to ask me, that'll be all.
Look, I know what I said earlier, but you've been hiding anything and everything about Sandrak being an immortal since day one. I deserve more than a report you wrote up.
Tell me, Jack, if you had a very close friend that you shared a common cause with for the longest time, a vision of what was right and true and good, and they betrayed that vision, betrayed you, how would you feel? Would you want to talk about it? Could you talk about it?
Yes, absolutely. I'd have to know how it even got to that point.
Sandrak and I were companion in arms for longer than you've been alive. We stood against the Kalthus Estates, the Sea King Usurper, the Colossals of the Arjaman Pretenders, even against Rasharn, his homeland. And then one day he refused to participate in a mission that could have very well ended the war.
What mission?
Read the report.
And we're back to that.
Look, what's important is that Sandrak had orders, and he allowed his own hubris to ignore them. He made a decision that jeopardized the rest of us because he thought he knew better.
Yeah. Hubris sure is some bad news. It's terrible.
For the breaking of his oaths to the Order, I exiled him back to Rasharn as punishment, thinking his ancestral enemies there would be the death of him.
That last part didn't work out.
Not even a little bit.
All right. I've got everything I need, sir.
Zendara and Devon should have already returned by now. You'll all set out for the Deep Mere in the morning. Oh, one more thing. The Oromic girl, Kenzie, she wanted to speak to you when you returned from the Shrine Forge. I think she's a bit smitten with you.
Yeah, I don't know if it's limited to just me, sir.